supporters say it is a way to ensure voter integrity. Opponents say it would do more harm than good. The push to require a photo ID comes from the Republican majority. They say it's what their constituents want and point to a 2016 vote by Missourians as proof. Voters overwhelmingly approved a constitutional amendment requiring a photo ID to vote. But the Missouri Supreme Court found the way the law was written to be unconstitutional. Lawmakers are making another attempt at passing voter photo ID legislation.
It's very concerning to me, and it should be to you, that the Missouri Supreme Court has flouted the clear intent of the people of Missouri when it comes to the common sense expectation that people show a photo form of ID when voting.
During testimony before the House Elections and Elected Officials Committee on Wednesday, opponents raised concerns. Some say requiring a photo ID disproportionately affects poor individuals because they are less likely to have the means to renew or obtain a photo ID.
It does water down the votes of people of color because they are especially likely not to be able to renew their license on time because they have a higher poverty rate in our state, three times higher.
Some committee members took exception to that argument, saying the state covers the costs for anyone without the means to obtain a state photo ID.
So there is no excuse. And when we hear the color of your skin or how much is in your bank account as excuses, that just doesn't cut it. Everybody can do it.
Representatives from the NAACP and the ACLU testified against the measure, believing it would keep some eligible voters away from the polls.
We should be very disturbed at the notion of stripping fundamental rights away from Missouri citizens.
Under the proposed legislation, a voter who fails to show a valid state photo ID would be allowed to cast a provisional ballot. Opponents have some concerns about how that process would work. Reporting from our Capitol Bureau in Jefferson City, I'm Jeff Bernthal.